Hi there, and welcome to a rather special podcast. I would like to introduce you to two very special guests indeed. They're here to answer all allegations that they are not real and that they're not pigs. I thought they were dead. I'd like you to open your hearts to, not open their hearts because that would be brutal, but open your hearts to the two wonderful singers that are Pinky and Perky. So, Pinky, how do you answer the allegations that many people, including myself, I'm afraid to say, have levelled at you, that you are not real and that you are not pigs?
Well, thank you very much, firstly, for giving us the chance to come in and clear our names and clear our reputations, because quite honestly, it's scandalous. What's happened to us? We were two hard-working jobbing pros, two hard-working pigs, and we were spotted by Mike Sams, that fraud that he is, who took all the credit for our work. Quite honestly, we came in, initially we thought it was a session gig, and we came in to do some work for him, and then, he started marketing us, and kept us out of the limelight, wouldn't let us go on TV for about 6 months, and when we agreed to go on, he said, we've got some puppets doing your work. It was union rules, there's a couple of pigs out there that were puppet pigs, and we were sat at home just watching the TV in absolute amazement. We couldn't believe it. Their performances were so wooden. We just didn't, we couldn't get out, couldn't do our work. And even Mike, he pulled strings to make sure that we didn't get work in the clubs. So we were really, for about 6 years, on a retainer. He did give us some money, but he didn't want us going out and playing and live. And to be honest, we were a bit rough at the edges in those days. Pinky went off the rails a bit. He started taking drugs and stuff, and we both, party hard, and we mixed with the wrong crowd, quite honestly. Led Zeppelin, they were on their way up in those days, and we used to hang out with those guys, it was a good scene, man. We would hang out in London, but we were always businesslike. We'd always be there banging out those tunes. In tune, in perfect tune, actually, for Mike whenever he required.
Well, that is absolutely incredible. I mean, what a story. I just didn't have any idea, quite honestly. So how did you guys, Pinky, can I ask you, Perky, I'm sorry, Perky, I still can't tell the difference between you guys. I mean, you're sitting opposite me now. One of you's got the hat on, haven't you?
I wear the bloody hat, right? That was Mike's idea again, because we are genetic twins, and people couldn't tell us apart, and I don't know why they needed to know who the hell we were, just Pinky and Perky, that's us, two of us. But people needed to know, am I looking at Pinky, am I looking at Perky? We used to have some fun with the ladies, I can tell you. So Mike, it was Mike's idea, he had this old beret hanging around one night, and we were having a good time, and Mike starts, prattling around, he puts the beret on, and one of the guests at the party said, Pinky, why don't you try it, and Perky, why don't you try it, and Perky put it on, we decided that it looked good. And it might be a way of distinguishing us apart. So that's how the berry thing got started.
Well, that's fascinating. So if we can go back, Perky, if I can ask you, how did you get started with your singing? I mean, what prompted you two pigs, to go into show business in the first place?
Well, the thing was, we were on the farm growing up as little piglets, and sometimes, we used to sneak into the house, and the farmer's wife would see us, she'd say, "Oh, you naughty pigs, out you go back to the trough," and she'd carry us out, But when we got a little bit bigger, it wasn't so cute, and we used to get hit with sticks. One day, Perky, who was always into a bit of reading, had come across a copy of Animal Farm. And in the story, the pigs took over the farm. So we started to get ideas, you know. And when the we didn't think the world was ripe for the revolution just at that time. But, you know, we started to go into the house and we'd creep upstairs. You know, when the family went away, you know, they used to go away for a weekend and we'd put on clothes and serve ourselves dinner and put on some of the old records and start singing along. And the animals would come to the window. We only allowed ourselves in, you know. And they were clapping and cheering and I think it was the cows who really got into it. They encouraged us and anyway, we got a good response and then we started to break out and sneak off and I think in the end we just left. We sort of outgrew the farm and when we got our clothes sorted out, we just went and started touring. And long story short, we end up in London and that fateful night, when Mike Sams comes across us singing in the Fiddler's Gibbet.
That started many acts at that time. It was well known as a kind of breaking ground, wasn't it? If you could do the Fiddler's Gibbet, you were going to get noticed. You were going to do well.
Yeah, that's right. The Fiddler's Gibbet. We went down a storm, and of course, in those days, our act was quite different from what people will remember, and the tracks that we eventually recorded, which were middle of the road nonsense, you know, from hits of the day. Obviously, that's where we found our success. But you know, in the Fiddler's Gibbet, we were really, really going for it. I mean, Perky used to do. So they talk about Zappa on stage, and Alice Cooper, but I mean, we were eating all sorts of nonsense. You know, because pigs. I mean, we can eat anything. People were throwing slurry up on stage, all sorts of offal and tripe and you know, I don't know what I was eating one night. And we would do all that, we would bust up the drum kit. We would go down to the cheapest music stores we could find and get instruments that we knew we were going to break the following night. Just as pure theatre, you know. But, I mean, Perky had one guitar, it was a Fender Stratocaster, and he used to stretch out and he used to do ridiculously long solos that would go on for a couple of weeks, you know. People would come and go and I mean, it was the 60s, man, you know, we didn't have any fears in those days. We just used to go on, but by the time Mike saw us, we had got it down to, you know, a nice tight little set, and he recognised our vocal ability, and basically we were quite lucky that night because we decided we just wanted to, you know, take the piss out of can I say that on the radio? Take the piss, take the piss out of some of the current artists. So we were doing like a cover version of I forget the song. Perky, do you remember what the song was? Yeah, I think. We were doing a cover version we were doing Taxman. Yeah, it was Taxman by the Beatles.
1 1 2 3 3 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 2 3 3 1 1 all.
Yeah, I'm not bloody surprised either. It's bloody rubbish. Anyway, Mike saw some promise and potential, and it was that night where, after a few beers and a few poppers and a few whizzes, that he offered us the contracts. Several contracts, actually, but as I remember. But in fact, it was just one on the table, Perky tells me.
Oh my goodness. Oh, well, those were the days, right? Oh, well, it's been absolutely fabulous talking to you guys, and I'm so happy that I bumped into you at the Dubai Mall. You know, who'd have thought that all these years after your great recordings and I happened to chance across you in Costa Coffee, literally days after making that podcast. So all the best to you guys. So, and I hear you're doing some shows in Dubai, right?
No, we're not doing any shows. You got the wrong end of the stick there, mate. We're just chilling, living off the immoral earnings of Mike Sams. We've managed to negotiate a much better deal and for our back catalogue, which we will be remastering. That's our next project. So, we're just chilling out here, you know, having a good time.
Well, we certainly wish you all the very, very best in that endeavour, and it was great to have you on the show.